Got to number two in the UK and number four.
Tony Blackburn, Sound of the 60s. Is that a Dome tone?
Well, certainly have to start thinking of getting my winter coat out. I'm fucking freezing. I've only been out of the car for about 30 seconds. I'm not going back and fucking right off. But I soon will, but.
There's White Lion Man doing his stuff. Spaceship coming into land. Close encounter. My editor, Deanne, came up on Thursday and we've actually finished the Silver State film. It took a long time, fucking COVID didn't help. We're supposed to have a screening in 2020 and I lost an editor. Then she came on board, wanted to change it, make it better. She's very good. And oh, now Adam is coming up today. He's composed some music for it. So, yeah. So once the music's on, I've then got to find a venue to screen it. Ideally, it'd be the community or one of the estate. But no cunt lives there now, except Chrissy Orney and a couple of new residents. I filmed. So, I'll try Goldsmiths. It's nearest a couple of stations and people can travel in. And anyway, yeah, let's get the music on first and then think about a venue. Look at them, they're going the wrong way. Lovely sight. So I can do one lap and go up the gym now. Yeah, because it's cold and it's warmer in the gym and I've seen all I want to see here. Lovely sky and a flock of geese. Job done.
Caress your waiting fingertips.
Singles from 1963, that was the number one. It's very weak in 63. The Beatles there and She Loves You. It got to number one in America as well. And in America initially the record made little impact until after the release of I Want to Hold Your Hand. That went to number one, leading the way for She Loves You to be reissued. And then of course it went to number one. So there you go, top three selling singles from 1963.
Alright kids, let's rock!